to find a new king to lead them. The old king Saul had turned away from God. So God sent his prophet Samuel to the house of a farmer called Jesse. I have chosen one of Jesse's sons to be the Israel's next king, he told Saul. Saul met some of Jesse's sons. They were all tall, handsome young men, and Samuel thought any of them could be king. God said, "No, not these." Finally, Jesse's youngest son came home after the sheep, from looking after the sheep. "This is the one," said God. "David used to sing and play his harp while watching his sheep, and he became well known for his wonderful songs." One day, King Saul was ill. He asked David to play for him, and it made him feel better. After that, David played and sang many times for the king. Three of David's brothers were soldiers in Saul's army. Jesse sent David out one morning with food for them. Now it happened that a huge giant called Goliath had challenged Saul's soldiers to come and fight him. If they won, the enemy would leave. "I'll fight him," said David. Saul did not want David to go. He was sure Goliath would kill him. But David faced Goliath knowing that God would be on his side. He wore no armor and had no weapon except the sling he kept to chase wild animals away from his sheep. Goliath roared with laughter when he saw David. David put a stone in his sling. He whirled it round his head and then let the stone fly. It hit Goliath on the forehead and he fell to the ground dazed. David took Goliath's sword and cut off the giant's head. David became a fine soldier and Saul put him in charge of his army. He won so many battles that the people started cheering him instead of King Saul. Saul did not like this at all and tried to kill David. David had to run away and hide. While he was searching for David, Saul stopped for a rest in the very cave where David was hiding. One of David's soldiers wanted to kill the king, but David stopped him. "I will not harm the man. God himself chose to be king of Israel," he said. After Saul died, the people made David their king. He was a very great ruler. David also wrote many songs in praise of God called Psalms, which are still sung today. The end. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment down below. See you in the next video. Bye!